Hello guys, I'm Alex. So you wanna make something like a radio or background music player? Let's do it. For simplicity's sake, we'll use a widget to play our music. You could use a game instance or create an actor for it or play it straight on your character. That's completely up to you. But if you also wanna display the song in text, we can do it on the widget for now. All right, let's create the widget. We'll search widget and we'll choose blueprint widget and user widget, W widget. I'll quickly set this up. Alright, I made a widget. Now, if you want to display the name of the track currently playing, we'll have to go and make an enumeration. Right click, search enumeration, we'll call it enum music player. In here we can write our track, so we'll go for 3. I've got here 3 tracks, great. We'll go back to our widget, we'll go to the event graph. Now we'll create an array for our music, so we'll call it music playlist. We'll switch this to a sound wave. You can use a sound cue depending on what you are using. And we'll switch this to an array by clicking here, compile, and we'll add 3. We'll pick our tracks. So you have to be careful to pick the tracks in the same order that you listed them inside the enumeration. So we have Kajel, Lexter, and Mindhivers. Kajel, Lexter, Mindhivers. Let's compile. We'll make a reference to our enumeration. And we'll search enum music. And a music player, compile. Oh, my bad, I forgot this step. We'll need to add our tracks in here as well to the array. And we'll also need one integer, song to play. We'll set this to an integer and to a single. We'll set the integer connected to event construct. Here we'll get random integer and we'll write this to 2 since it goes 0, 1, 2. And we have 3 tracks and that's 3 numbers, 0, 1, 2. We'll do play sound 2D. We'll get our music playlist array. We'll do get a copy. We'll plug the integer song to play here and then we'll plug the get into our play sound 2D. Afterwards, we'll get our music playlist enumeration. We'll also do get and plug again the same integer here as well. So we have the same number for both this array and this enumeration. We'll need to make sure that our text it's marked as a variable, which it is, and we'll call this song playing and we'll drag the song playing here. We'll get and we'll set text, connect it right here. Then from the enumeration playlist, we'll get to text and we'll connect this to our set text. I think this is it for our widget. So now we'll go to our character and on begin play, we'll create a widget and we'll select the widget that we created and we'll get player controller so that the widget knows which player to attach to and we'll add to viewport. All right, great. Now let's see if this works. We'll press play. It's working properly. Nice. Now, if you'd like to change the song, what we can do is we'll get duration of our playing song and we can do a delay. We'll connect the delay and we'll just have it loop back the whole thing again. So this is what's happening. When the game starts, we choose a random number from 012. We feed that number to our get copies from our music playlist array and music playlist enumeration. The music enumeration is used to display the track playing and the music array holds the actual sound files. Afterwards, we feed the track selected to play sound 2D, which will play the song, and then we get the track currently playing to display as text in the widget via this text. Afterwards, we grab the duration of the current song playing and add it to a delay, and once this delay finishes running, it will loop the entire thing again to play a different song picked at random, or you can make it to play a whole playlist one by one. To do that, you can delete a random integer and you can get the song to play. You can add one, which will save it here. And now each time it will play the first song, then the second, then the third, each time one song finishes. And if you like to edit the volume, you can open the play 2D sound and you can reduce the volume here. We'll do like 0.4. And this will play at a different volume. If you like a tutorial for how to make a music player with buttons, let me know in the comments. Like and subscribe.